Good evening, and welcome along to The Big Show here on NVTV. Coming up on the show this evening, I'll be chatting to comedian William Caulfield.
We'll also have some live music from the archives with Janet Henry and Brand New Friend.
And would you ever let your wife cut your hair?
I would. I've always said that I could do it, and we'll see how I get on the show later on.
So she did do it, and we'll find out how I got on with that haircut before the end of the show. Talking about haircuts, did you see the viral video of farmer Donny Anderson that went viral? It got about 1 million views in the first 24 hours, and has had many more ever since. Now, he had a go at cutting his hair with some sheep shears. Don't try this at home, ladies and gentlemen.
I think this needs to be done. It'll grow back in a couple of days, so nobody will notice it, anyway. Get some off, anyway. Tell me if I missed a bit.
There we go, a fabulous viral video of farmer Donny Anderson.
And don't forget to stay tuned, because you'll get a chance to see me work out my skills as a hairdresser and stopping Robin from looking like the nutty professor.
That's still to come, but right now we're going to be chatting to comedian William Caulfield. Before we do, if you've been on William's Facebook page recently, you would have noticed the Locals in Lockdown series featuring some of your favourite Our Jimmy characters and finding out how they're getting on during the coronavirus pandemic. So we'll start off by showing you one of these. So here's Derek.
Yes, I've caught me. Well, I'm just cleaning the windows for my mommy, because during this whole coronavirus thing, she likes to be able to see out, you know, if she can't get out herself. She's up in years, like she's 87, so she'd be one of them ones that, you know, would be in a high risk group. But she was saying to me just the other day, she says, son, she says, isn't it good all the same that we have sunshine at the present time? Because sometimes she comes out and she sits in the yard and the sun's shining down on her. And she was just saying to me last night, she says, son, I hope this whole thing is over before the summer, so that we maybe get a wee holiday. And right enough now, I would be the same. I'm hoping it's over too. Because I have saved up, you know what I mean, like to buy my mom a wee holiday, because last year we didn't have. We went away for the first time last year. And we went to one of the Costas. I can't remember which Costa it was, but I know it cost a fortune. And we flew, you know what I mean? And Mummy had never been in an airplane before. And right enough, she's very worried about getting in. And she says to me, like, are the air hostages, like, are they nice? I says, oh, yes, they're very, very nice. So we were sitting and we took off. And she says, I'm very warm. She says, I wonder if we get a window open. Say, mammy, in an airplane, you cannot open a window. Like, my mummy didn't know. And then she nudged me. I seen her fidgeting. And she nudged me and she says, son, she says, I need to go to the yard. Would there be a yard? And I said, well, I think there's one at the front, maybe one at the back. So before I knew what was happening, I hear called Stuart. I says, who is Stuart? Says, him there. I says, it's a nurse, Stuart's name, not Stuart. Well, she called him in and she says, I need to go to the yard. And he looked at me as much as to say, I have no clue what she's talking about. I says, he's going to the toilet. So she went up to the front of the plane with the wee cabin steward there. And I was kept on reading my book. Well, it wasn't actually reading a book, it was a Kindle, so I kept pressing the pages. And there was a commotion at the front. I have no idea what was going on. So I thought, what happened? Has happened to my mummy? So I went up to the front, and there she was, very white. And she says, son, she says, I was sitting in there minding my own business. And she says, I had done my business, if you understand me. And then she says, by mistake, and I mean by mistake, my elbow hit the button. And she says, there was a sucking noise. And she says, son, I know that you and me is heading to the Costa. But she said, by heaven's my backside, back in Aldergrove. Oh, we laughed. My mummy can be a gig.
Later.
So there we go, that's a clip from Locals in Lockdown, which of course features all your favourite Our Jimmy characters, courtesy of comedian William Caulfield, who joins us now on the line. William, how are you?
I'm wonderfully well, thank you. How are you?
I'm great. And isn't it great with technology these days that we can do this online?
Isn't it just, you can now see that the beard has grown back a little. I had to. The reason I was so reluctant to do the Locals in Lockdown was I knew I'd have to shave my beard. but I was put under pressure. But a very good friend of mine said, "No, you should really do it. You should really do it." And so I did. And the thing about them was there was no scripts. Yeah. I put on the costume, pointed the iPhone up, and started talking. So some of them are good, and others aren't. Well, they're just all right.
Now, so far, we've seen Derek, we've seen Billy Hulk, and we've seen Orange Lily. So, who else do we have to look forward to?
I did enjoy Hulk.
Yeah.
So, who else do we have to look forward to?
Who else is coming? The wee schoolboy, the drunk Willie Simpson, and Lily O'Condrack. Yeah, so those three are still to come. And then if lockdown continues, this will have to come off again. And I'd have to do the... Because I've been lying out in the sun thinking about them, yeah, and I've been thinking of the Cherry Valley woman, the woman from Cherry Valley. I need to do her and probably the Ballymena man or Aunt Sarah from Ballymena. And have some other ideas for some of the other characters. So I may do a batch more. I don't know.
Brilliant. So I would imagine if you weren't in lockdown at the moment, you'd be cruising around the world somewhere, wouldn't you?
Well, let me just tell you exactly where I would be today. As I look, now, there's something nobody needed. Wasn't it a 2020 calendar? I should have been actually leaving a ship in Rome today, or just beside Rome. So that is gone. Next week I was to fly to Dubai, week after over to Denmark and Poland, and at the end of the month fly to New York City. I know none of that's happening because I just got an email before I spoke to you from the ships. Everything's now cancelled to the end of July. But it's, you know, there's no point in me saying, ah, for flip's sake. It's just everybody's in the same position. And thankfully, I'm always a glass half full type of guy. And I've just went, well, okay, that's what it is. That's what it is.
So just before we went into lockdown and all this happened, you were cruising all around the place. You were in places like Australia and Tasmania, weren't you?
Yes, I was. When we were all aware of that this was a problem, I was in Australia, and I was normally I only go on a ship for a week and then come home. But when I was so far away down in Australia, I was out there for 4, maybe 5 weeks. So I was joining different ships, and the first problem that I encountered was I was to fly from one ship to another ship. And they were both Cunard ones, and they said, no, that's not happening anymore. We're not doing transshipping. And I said, so have I to go home? And says, no, you're going to stay on this ship because guests were getting off, you guests were getting on, so it wouldn't matter. So I said, well, that's okay. And then the next morning we were told, no, New Zealand had then closed its ports, and I was to be flown home. being on the ship, actually, I felt very safe. And not because I work on the ship am I going to be standing up for them. The cruise lines have got a very, very bad press out of this. In the world, there was 1,500 cases. That's all.
Yeah.
Only 1,500 cases. But people said, oh, no, it's cruise lines. I felt really safe on the ship because I was getting my temperature taken every day. Everywhere you go, there was hand sanitizers. It was very, very much health focused. So, and there was no cases on the ship, so I felt really safe there. There was once I stepped on land and thought, oh, what is this thing? And the flights home, one of the planes was sparse. There was very few of us on it. But the last one, which was from, America, they flew me that way, was packed, rammed full. And I thought, oh, there's no, what is it? Just wash your hands. There is no problem here. But sad to say, there is a problem. And in fact, this morning, my stepmother's in a care home, and I hadn't seen her from before I went away to Australia. And I've just been told that there are now cases in the care home that she's in. So hoping and praying that everything is okay. But it's real. It is a real thing. So I have lost some gigs. At least, you know, I haven't lost my life, and loved ones at this stage haven't. But we know we're talking to people, and loved ones have lost their life. So it is a big thing.
So tell us about Tasmania. It's a place that you would never really think of going to. But I read in one of your blogs that it's a really beautiful place, isn't it?
Tasmania was lovely. New Zealand is my favourite country in the world now. Really? In fact, I think the last time I was talking to you on one of your shows, I'd been to Australia, but I hadn't been to New Zealand because, if you remember, my brother had died and I had to come back.
Yeah.
And I was looking forward to going back to New Zealand. New Zealand is worth it. Oh, what a beautiful country. Lovely people. The country itself is absolutely fantastic. I love the attitude of the New Zealand people. I'm coming to Tasmania. I heard your question. the attitude of the people is brilliant because they don't care. And they openly don't care. I went into any coffee shop or restaurant you'll go into, there'll be a sign, no split bills. Right? So that just doesn't happen. And there was a lovely one in New Zealand in a place called Napier. There was a coffee shop called the I think it was called the Six Sisters. And there was a sign, there's a sign up, if your allergies are that bad, go somewhere else. Just love, you know, if your food allergies are that bad, go somewhere, because we can't be bothered with that. And I thought, well, yeah, I knew what they meant. You know, they're only a small family, so they couldn't cater for all of them. It was just, your allergies are bad, go somewhere else. And then we sailed to Tasmania, and Tasmania was really, really beautiful. Of course, we were blessed with fabulous weather when we were there. Tasmania, I think, have had no cases of COVID-19 because they closed straight away and said, not letting anybody in. And it certainly was never a place that I would sit at home and say, I'd love to go to Tasmania.
Yeah.
I just knew where it was. I didn't see any devils when I was there. But it was I think all the devils are back home here. But it was nice to be there and nice to have done that. And I really hope that when this passes and when things return to whatever the new normal is, none of us know what that is, that I'll get back down to that part of the world because it really is lovely.
So would you ever think about doing a travel show? I follow all your stuff on social media, and I think you'd be great doing a travel show on all your travels.
I'm going to be honest with you. I'm too lazy. Because the bit that people don't know that when I'm on the ship, right, I'm there for a week.
Yeah.
I do one 45-minute show in that week, maybe two, okay? And that's all I do. So that when I don't have a show day, I'm just relaxing. And for me to think about doing a travel show, that would be, I have to get up and work today. So what I have done is, if you've followed me, is I do a little Facebook Live wherever I am, and just a little snippet of here's this or here's that. But if someone was to say to me, now William, when you're there doing that and getting paid to do that, if you do a sort of a travel show and we pay you for doing that, well then that's a different thing. Yeah, they pay me for doing it, I do it.
So what's next when lockdown is over? Is there going to be more Our Jimmy?
Our Jimmy's, my next Our Jimmy, I think, is scheduled for, I keep going to this redundant book. The next Our Jimmy is scheduled for, well, the 16th of October.
Yeah, well, let's hope we're out of lockdown by then.
Now, remember, I'm a glass half full guy.
Yeah.
I don't see the theatres being open, or if they are, let's say a theatre holds 500, they'll probably only let in 200.
Yes. Yeah.
And they'll keep empty seats. I would think, if I was a theatre manager, I would say, well, look, that's the way to do it. I would have loads of hand sanitizer at the door with the ushers, making sure that you did your hand and then you went and watched the show. But sure, there could be a vaccine by then. We don't know. There's smarter and wiser men than you and me, and women, sorry ladies, working to make the world a healthy place again.
So what's life in lockdown like for you? What are you currently binge-watching on TV?
Yes, I have binge-watched. the fact that I don't get so long to be at home, it's a novelty still that I'm at home. The only problem I have is that you can't meet people for coffees. You know, it'd be great if they relax the coffee shop, but how do they do that? I don't know. It would just be nice to go and meet someone, and then life for me would be, oh, this is just what I'm like when I'm not on the ships. But it is lockdown, and yes, thanks to O2, there are other providers. When I recently updated my phone, they gave me Netflix free for 6 months, which was about a year and a half ago, and I became absolutely hooked on it. And actually, just before the lockdown, when I come back from Australia, I bought a new television for the house, which was, you know, Ultra K, 4, whatever, I don't know what it is. But I know Netflix said if I paid them another £2 a month, they would stream the stuff in this. So I signed up for that as well. A friend of mine said to watch a show called Power, P-O-W-E-R.
Yes, right. Yeah.
Have you seen it?
Yeah, we're on season 4 or season 5 of Power.
I watched it all in about 3 weeks. Now, it's brutal.
Yeah.
It's graphic. But it just draws you in. Who did that? What happened? What? And that is fabulous. Just finished watching that. I'm now on to, I think it's the Sky Atlantic Gangs of London. Or
it's great, but how brutal is it?
Well, and I'm sitting thinking, is this what I've turned into? But it's escapism, you know. It's certainly not going to make me, as soon as lockdown finishes, go out and try and buy a gun.
No, but all these gangs, they all seem to have some kind of Jackie Chan or Bruce Lee martial arts training, don't they?
And the question I ask is, why is the police not watching that house? you know the house I mean, I'm not going to give it away.
Yeah.
You know, when they all come out with their guns, like, well, what's going on? So, yeah, Netflix or Sky Atlantic or whatever, but yeah, I've loved that. And another thing that I found on Netflix is, you know, I'm a big Formula One fan, and I hadn't had my fix at Formula One, but there was a show on Netflix, followed the teams on Formula One, had unfettered access, and it was fabulous as well, because it wasn't so much as following the racing as following the team and following the actual guys. So I binge-watched that as well. So that's good. So any recommendations?
Now tell me this. Have you seen that Tiger King?
I watched the first episode and I went, why is everybody into this? I watched the second episode and I haven't returned to it. No, it's not for me.
Now I see you're in your office at the moment. Are you one of these people like Bob Monkhouse that has joke books all over the place? I see on your shelves behind you there all the files. Are they files full of jokes?
Very sad. See those files? The ones at the top are accounts. Then there's contracts and bank statements and non-VAT receipts and things like that. Over at the other side here, We do have, this is all our Jimmy stuff. So those three files is full of old scripts that I've used on stage or radio or whatever. There's diaries and things there. There's absolutely no joke books as such. I do have my own that I write stuff down. but I don't have a big volume of stuff like Bob Monkhouse had, no.
All right.
Most of it with me, rather than writing stuff down, I'll have an idea, rough idea, and then if I'm doing the Jimmy characters, when I put on the costume, because there's, you know, I get mention that, then things just evolve as I become the character more than anything else than writing stuff down. But I do make notes, yeah.
All right. To finish off, will you give us a laugh? Will you do one of your gags to cheer us all up?
Okay, this guy went to the doctor, and the doctor says, "Now, I've examined you," and he says, "Here, see these yellow pills." He says, "I want you to take two of them in the morning with a glass of water, two more in the afternoon with a glass of water, two in the early evening with a glass of water, and two before you go to bed with a glass of water. Then these red ones, I want you to take three of them with a glass of water." About halfway between, you took the yellow ones with a glass of water, right through the rest of the day, take those. And the guy says, "That's an awful lot of tablets, doctor. What's wrong with me?" He says, "You ain't drinking enough water."
Brilliant. William Caulfield, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much for inviting me on the show. To anybody that sees or listens to this, stay at home, stay safe, and protect your NHS.
So there we go. Let's take another locals in a lockdown now. And this time, here's a character that we all know and love. Here is Mrs. O'Condrack.
See, with this old coronavirus, you're only allowed out once a day to get your messages, and I've just been getting my messages. I've just got the essential stuff that you have to get, like walnut whips and Aero bars and cigarettes. And I've got some of them Haribos, although I don't like eating too many of them because they get stuck on my teeth. And I've got my crisps and I've got my Pringles. You know, like the normal stuff that you have to get. And I hope our Emily Beattie's not looking out or she'd want to take the stuff off my... Like, don't be telling her, but I got some wee luxuries as well. You know, like milk and butter. I'm juking out because my front doorbell rung and I know rightly it's Emily Beattie. She'd sicken you so she would. She comes over in the morning for a bowl of sugar and she's here half the day. Oh, it's her roast, I'm back. Did she see me? Don't think she did. No, we're saving up now, the coast clear. Things you have to do during this whole coronavirus.
And if you want to see some more of William Caulfield's Locals in a Lockdown, just head over to his Facebook page.
And now some live music from Janet Henry with a track called Scared.
Switching on.
case.
Now, some stuff that we've been watching on TV recently, and William was talking to us about the series Power. We've been watching that. There's been about six seasons of this so far, hasn't there?
Yeah, and it's gripping because, you know, he's playing a double life. So you get a chance to see him as a drug dealer, but he's also a nightclub owner, and it's all sort of, you know, he's cleaning the money through the nightclub, and so it's drugs, and there's the detective, and then, you know, his lover, and oh, it's all just so exciting because, you know, he's married as well. So
Power tells the story of James Ghost St. Patrick, a wealthy New York nightclub owner who has it all, catering to the city's elite and dreaming big. He leads a double life as a drugs kingpin. Here's a clip from Power.
We finally got to a nightclub.
People come here and become whoever they want to be for the night. It's a fantasy.
It's the best nightclub opening the whole year. We can go national, international even.
It's the truth!
You still haven't told me how you made this happen.
Our goal is the prosecution of one of the most notorious drug traffickers in our hemisphere.
We open up a nightclub to hide the money.
What if it could be more than that, though, man?
I just want it to stay this way.
I won't be a drug dealer forever, Tasha.
Everybody starts out small. Question is, what do you want to make of yourself?
You don't just become a good guy, Jamie. You are always one inside.
This club is the dream. We can get out.
You really believe that?
If you don't want a war, there's only one way to stop it.
Now, something else that's streaming on digital platforms at the moment is Birds of Prey, the new Harley Quinn movie starring Margot Robbie. And after splitting with the Joker, Harley Quinn joins superheroes Black Canary, Huntress, and Renee Montoya to save a young girl from an evil crime lord. Here's a clip of Birds of Prey.
A lot of people in this city want me dead. And at the top of that list is Black Mass.
Hold, please.
He's after all of us.
He bought himself an army.
I think he can manage a couple of little girls.
Unless we all want to die very unpleasant deaths, we're going to have to work together. That felt pretty great.
So that's Birds of Prey with Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn.
And Margot Robbie, you know, was in Neighbours way, way back. And she was a really popular character. I thought she was brilliant. I'm really pleased that she's moved on. Playing Harley Quinn is a bit different for her because she plays all sorts of different roles. She's very versatile. I think she's great.
Now, was she in Neighbours at the same time as Joe Mangold? And...
Oh, no. Years later. Years later.
All right, okay. Right, Birds of Prey is streaming now on digital platforms, and it arrives on DVD and Blu-ray from the 15th of June.
Right, now it's my big moment. Let's see how I get on cutting Robin's hair.
Okay, so Robin is in the chair. You may ask what he's doing there. A few weeks back, he said he would not let me near his hair. But as you can see, it's getting very, very long and he's letting me do it. So the first thing I'm going to do is show you some of the tools that I have gotten. I got this from the Pine Shop. It's all different types of combs, just in case I need it. So I also got these more looking professional ones as well, just in case. Now, with regards to scissors, I have two options. One, embroidery scissors from the Pine Shop.
What?
And normal kitchen scissors that I already had in the house. Are you still nervous, Robin?
Very.
Don't worry.
Can I just check, have you taken advice from an expert on this?
Of course I have, Robin.
Have we got Paul Meekin on hand just in case something goes wrong?
Paul Meekin is definitely on hand. He did a video a few weeks ago on how to do a fringe.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to give it a wee go. I'll just do a few wee bits to start with, Robin, so don't panic.
Right, okay.
So the first most important thing for me to do would be to get my own hair out of the way. I mean, we don't want to make any mistakes on mine, you know, cut mine accidentally instead of Robin's. So here we go. So, okay, so I don't have a sprayer because I've got all my disinfectant in the sprayers. So I'm just using my hand to just dampen up the hair. You nervous, Robin?
Very.
We should have really had a towel around you, but sure, don't be worrying. So I'm going to start at the back.
The best place to start when nobody can see what kind of mess you're going to make down there.
Well, exactly. So I'm going to just... I've seen this being done in the hairdresser, so I'm just going to... Oh, gosh. Right. Okay, here we go.
Now, watch the ears. Watch the ears.
It's all right. I'm nowhere near your ears. Here we go.
Now. And what scissors are you using? Because it sounds like you're slicing with
I'm trying to do this, you know, in like one that he said to do, but... It's actually easier to just do exactly the opposite of what he said. But then it is quite long. So maybe once I've got the ends off, I can sort of fix it a wee bit. Let's see what happens here. No, that's not too bad. I think you'll be quite pleased, Robin. That's what I've done so far. I don't think that's too bad. It's only one side.
Well, there's less of it.
There's definitely less of it.
I can feel that. Is it? Is it a good job? Is it a good job? Is it?
I don't think it's too bad. I've got to get down here a wee bit. It's still a wee bit.
Oh, I felt that.
What?
Okay, now for the front bit. Now, I think we need to leave it kind of quite heavy on top so we don't see any mistakes that are made.
Okay, well, let's start this wee side bit first.
Okay.
I'm a bit nervous here myself. Okay, hold on. No, it's all right. We'll get it sorted. See, they make it look so easy, but they've been training for years. Let's try a wee bit of the very front then. Okay, it's quite long at the minute anyway, so... Yeah. I don't really, it's this cut in that I'm a bit worried about, so, that he had mentioned. So just hold that for me. Thank you. Definitely looks easier than it is. Aye, that's not too bad. What do you think?
So there we go. That's what happened. Here's how it's turned out. I think it's turned out okay.
I told you it would. I've said all along that I could cut Robin's hair. I've been saying it for quite a long time. But he was always frightened to let me anywhere near it because he would have needed to make sure that I was in a good form with you, wouldn't you, Robin? But I actually think it's turned out really good. I'm really pleased. But of course, I did have some help with it from Paul Macon because he was on the show a few shows ago, and I also reminded myself of some of his videos cutting hair. So yeah, I'm really pleased. I think you should be really pleased because now you've got a hairdresser skill. In your wife.
All right, there we go. Right, that's nearly all we have time for on the big show tonight. We're going to leave you with some live music from the archives and a track called I Hate It When You Have to Go. This is A Brand New Friend. See you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Lights in car parks that we pretend are stars, and I purposely make wishes through the window of her car.
You spin me faster than I could ever spin myself. A missing puzzle piece I do believe belonged to someone else. And the stories that you told me, well, they're all coming true. And I just can't shake the feeling that I won't get over you. In the pictures that you drew of me, you painted a smile. It's the first one that I've seen in weeks, but the last one for a while. She said so.
go. I hate it when you have to go. I only wanted the best for us from the start. You gotta believe me, I may be blinded by the future, but I don't have a selfish heart. I believe so much, cause this is no more than we deserve. We're friends in a room who love each other and still get on each other's nerves. And the stories that you told me, well, they're all coming true. And I just can't shake the feeling that I won't get over you. In the pictures that you drew of me, you painted a smile. It's the first one that I've seen in weeks, but the last one for a while. She said so, I guess I know.
I hate it when you have to go.
I hate it when you have to go.
I hate it when you have to go.